top off the net, and she misses a sitter, Miwa. Wow. I hope that's a sign of things to come entertainment-wise, Neha.
Yeah, Fraser, you know I'm smiling all this while thinking, just put things in perspective. Miwa Harimoto is only 14 years old. Barely in high school.
And she's the best cadet in the world. She's a cadet.
Yeah.
Cadet. This girl hasn't even taken a GCSEs yet. Or whatever the equivalent is in Japan.
And love this thing about sport, right? That people from all nations, all ages, all backgrounds have the ability to be there and express themselves. And the one who's better on the table on that day will take away the show.
Indeed, indeed. Nice fluid backhand, stamps the foot on the serve to mask the indication of how much spin she put on there. Brilliant redirection there from Chun Suyu. Couldn't even get back to ball there, Miwa, as fast as she is. Wide forehand exposed. Taste of the own medicine there.
Yeah, it was tit for tat out there. A lovely serve by Chen Ziyu.
Indeed. And she will have played many players younger than her before. So I don't think she'll even be thinking about that right now. She knows the Harimoto threat. And she's just treating her as another opponent. Slowing things down there. And Miwa disrupted by that change of pace. You could see it. She came in for the counter actually too early. And it didn't come through as she thought it would. Switching as soon as she can. And that, I think, will be a telling sign as to who may win this match. Whoever can switch wide first really has the best chance of winning the rally. She knows she's up for a scrap here, Miwa.
Yeah, slowly getting in the game, settling in well. She's trying to increase the pace now in both her spins and the receives to match what Chen Ziyu has to offer.
Wow, brave step around. But it was so strong that Miwa, even though she saw the opportunity, couldn't play it down the line to the open space. Miwa Harimoto has just beaten Kasumi Ishikawa in the previous round. Now, if that isn't telling the Japanese coaches that she's ready now, I don't know what is. Wow! She braces for impact there after somehow recovering it from the middle. Incredible play from the 14-year-old prodigy. I thought that may have hit her shirt for a second, that forehand.
Yeah, and it seemed like she was so sure of that backhand that it was a simple guiding the ball. Very, very confident. And again, Fraser, you rightly said it is a game of who can make that switch first and leave the forehand not open.
Guess what bat she's using, Miwa Harimoto? Her brother's personal signature blade.
Wow, now that is a story. How beautiful this is.
Wow, I mean, that tells you, doesn't it? The characteristics of that blade being similar, that she's trying to replicate what her brother is, and that's definitely come from their parents. Has to have.
For sure, they're aggressive, both on the court. They love finishing the rally quickly. Wonder how they'll make as a mixed doubles pair.
Oh, Strawberry push, counter wide. It does not get any better than that. He said, I do not want to live in the shadow of my brother. I want to pave my own way in the sport, have my own name, achieve my own things.
One day indeed, with the level of table tennis she's shown in the last 6 points, she will surely make her mark soon at the international arena, just like her brother has done.
Like her brother beat Jun Mitsutani, she beat Ishikawa. And now she's here. Expect to see a lot more of Miwa Hanamoto. She'll be someone that the fans love to watch, but her opponents hate to play, and she's going to be around for a very, very long time. So get used to seeing her here on show courts at such events. Jumping when she played that parallel forehand.
And her age.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Just a little bit upright when she played that backhand and took it slightly earlier. She could have afforded more dwell. Forehand you want to take early, backhand you can take a bit later. Well, she's going for the strawberry push more than she's going for the strawberry flick, which tells me that she's happy to counter a heavy topspin ball, Miwa Hanamoto. Not afraid to send the ball long with backspin. She knows what's going to come, a slow spin.
That was a dead ball, I believe.
Yep. Contacted it probably towards the bottom of the racket, so not as much topspin. So low to the net, though, and great anatomical contortion. She also beat Min Hyun Ji of Australia in the round of 48 before toppling the poster girl of Japan, Kasumi Ishikawa. Jansu Yu defeated Linda Bergström, the Swedish chopper, 3-1 in the previous round. She had a bye, Jansu Yu, into the main draw. Didn't have to play the round of 48 as a seed. Winner of this match will play the winner of Chen Yi and Manika Batra. Manika facing her toughest test yet in the Chinese left-handed young player, coming player, Chen Yi. She's already won a contender and feeder, not a star contender.
Much more stability here in this game from Chen Siyu. If she can control her unforced errors, I think she's already in the game then.
Good flick. Miwa Hanamoto, too upright, and came up the back of an already very topspin ball. She looks like her brother, doesn't she?
For sure she does.
Slightly different hairstyle though. The base is so wide, I've noticed, of Miwa. So wide. Which makes her automatically lower and more balanced. Chen Siyu frustrated. She has the serves though.
A lot of tapping of the foot you saw here, Fraser, and it tells so much that she's trying to control the ball a lot.
The
but unsuccessful.
Mm.
Yeah.
Mm. Ooh, just overextending, Miwa.
She's been a bit erratic in this game, I believe.
Yeah, for sure. Oh, That's the better percentage. Like that.
And I think I heard an Indian fan saying, come on, Meva.
Unreal. That is the best women's rally we may have seen in terms of athletic display here on table one so far.
She was forced behind the table, and look how, despite going back, she comes onto the table, back into the rally. Oh, the reverse pendulum, you saw that for the first time in this game so far.
I can't remember it. When I commentated the final between herself and Zhang Wei at the Contender last season, I can't recall her ever playing the reverse pendulum. Is this a new weapon in her inventory, or did she always have it but just not use it? Controlling her breathing, you can really see that. Chen Xiaoyu's going to have to do the same. Two ahead still, highest ranked player from Team Chinese Taipei, with two serves to come as well, so be happy with that. Two away.
Got it, go.
Oh, nice.
Well strategized though.
Very.
And suddenly you see the switching of extreme forehand is not working anymore.
No. Nice. Because she took that second backhand a bit longer. Chen Xiaoyu thought she was going to go cross court, but she didn't. It was a double bluff from Miwa Haramoto. Got the serves here, serving for survival in the second game. The arena here, everyone in it, captivated. Ah! What a serve.
I'm still puzzled. Was it a deep, it was a top spin or
backspin.
Was a long backspin?
Long backspin, I believe.
Yeah, but that was a, it was out for Chen Xiaoyu. Wow, so brave from Miwa Haramoto. She isn't shy of playing what she knows the best. Close to the table, and look at that forehand, so deep and wide on the backhand side. Fraser here is speechless.
I'm impressed. I'm seriously impressed with this. Oh, a net for Chen. That's a way to break the momentum. Breaking the net cord. And she does it. She escapes by the skin of her teeth. Chen Xiaoyu. Another net cord initially. But she was trying to go into the middle. So good tactics. It wasn't, say, a 100% fortunate shot where it hits the hand, hits the net. Nice control. A lot of down the middle play now.
Back to the strategy of game one.
Let one on.
And if you're new to table tennis and wondering why do players hit end up hitting the net cord, is because they want the ball to stay as low as possible near the net. Which is much harder for the opponent to send it back, because the ball will be lower, and then they got to flex it more, they got to produce more spin and work more to send the ball back.
Well, if Miwa Haramoto is going to play the strawberry push long, needs to get that bat high quick, ready to counter, because Chen Shiyu is going to grease it with topspin, and she's probably going to put it into the middle or forehand, because she knows how good Miwa can punch cross court.
Excellent use of the shovel serve by Miwa.
Like so many of the Japanese women do, we know Hirano really brought it into fashion. With the serves, Chen Shiyu. Good flick through the fingers. The thumb pressured, the forefinger loose, the wrist loose, and some springiness through the forearm. Comes around the side of that. The banana flick, aka the Chiquita flick. Direct. A lot of players now are choosing to actually dominate play from the middle with the backhand side, because it's a less expensive stroke. It takes less time to recover from a backhand than it does with the forehand.
Yeah, and also it could probably give you more angle on the deep corner.
5-4. You can see where your opponent's moving in front of you, which is similar to the backhand serve. With the pendulum serve, when you're on the side, you've got to look in your peripheral. You don't when you're all square to the table. Kicker, but she came up the back of the ball, Miwa. It's her bat height that is her difficulty right now. Her bat's too low. Should be higher to be able to get over the top of the balls. That was a lovely ball. Stamped to exaggerate it as well.
Yeah, and both the players are just maintaining form. It's so nice to see the game be as close as possible right now. That is a much more animated Harimoto.
Nice pivot. Transition through the ball there. Miwa Harimoto with some very, very good technique.
And I've not seen that more often in this game so far. This is probably the first time she did the step around on the serve.
Maybe she needs to hunt more attackable balls with the forehand.
Yeah, and that's what it is for attackers, right? You have to hunt. The ball will not be given to you on the plate. You got to hunt for the right opportunities to create a good opening for you to then smash the balls.
What a turnaround. Blink and you miss it.
Beautiful it is. 8-5 in no time.
Nice, she is so good for a 14-year-old. I wonder if she'd be as good as Kwai Man is when she's 18. Probably at this rate, if you assume any rate of improvement over time, she will be unbeatable for some of these Chinese women, because China do not have a 14-year-old as good as Miwa Harimoto. Otherwise, maybe they would be here, maybe they wouldn't, but I don't think they do. And when you look at Tomokazu beating Liang Yanning.
Absolutely beautiful from Chen Shiyu. And this is what she needs to do to survive in the game. Just up the speed and go for the attack early on. Yeah, just applying subtle more pressure than what she was in the previous two games.
I think a good tactic of Chen Shiyu could be actually pinning the forehand over and over again of Miwa Harimoto. Forehand to forehand, she was beating her. Seems to recover a little bit quicker on the forehand, Chen, than Miwa. The follow-through of Miwa's forehand is bigger. That's the reason why.
Yeah, she takes much more time. There's a twist when she allows to twist and then makes the forehand attempt.
That was nice. Just in awe of that push, how heavy the initial push was, but Chen Shiyu dealt with it so well with the backhand brush up.
Yeah, Yeah, slight change in the positioning. It was a very nice body. It was not... It was a good middle that Chen Ziyu found from Miwa Harimoto. And like you said, Fraser, she allows time for forehand, and thus it is important to find the middle because the wingspan for Harimoto is slightly larger than Chen Ziyu.
Are we going to a fifth, ladies and gentlemen? Looks like it, but we know how fast things can turn around. Look at Elizabeth Samara up against Chung Yi Ching in the fourth game, early on in the day. 9-2. She turned it around and won the game.
Yeah, looks like slipping from Miwa Harimoto this game.
She beat Chen last time. It's different settings now.
That was simply insane. The backhand and the rolling of the wrist, Fraser. Just look at that. So clean, so sharp, right in the body. No answers from Chen Ziyu. And you get one more.
Hang on. It's coming back again.
No. She misses that.
No way, Jose. You thought it was over, didn't you, Neha?
I surely did. And this is going to hurt Harimoto a lot.
Oh, it was like a praying mantis, that action.
It was beautiful. It felt like she's doing the shovel serve, but she ended up doing the side spin pendulum. Just beautiful deception by Miwa.
Chen Ziyu really hasn't had to make too many big shots to win this game. And it again proves the point that the game is becoming closer to the table with shorter and sharper strokes. The changing ball has had a huge impact. And I think the recognition that you don't want to give your opponent too much time has made players want to play closer to the table.
I love the intention though. Just look at how aggressive she was.
Right, doesn't matter about what the score is. She's going to be aggressive regardless.
Five, nine.
Beautiful dummy spin.
She had a disappointing feeder. She lost to Wu Yang Chen of China, who's a good player, but Miwa would have hoped to beat her. She's coming from that tournament now, playing leaps and bounds better.
6-9.
And she's 6-9 down, but she can finish this game well, regardless of what happens. She's going to make Chen Ziyu a little bit more nervy going into the fifth game if it goes to that stage. Let's see.
9-7.
This is getting tense.
Yeah.
I think it was the second game where she recovered.
Yes.
From 2 points down.
Yes, yes. I think it was. Clever. Kicker. That's the beauty of the shovel. You don't know where the ball is going to dig and whether it is. 10-7. 3 game points.
Wow. Beautiful. Brave from Miwa Harimoto. She actually increases the pace and the spin in that receiving as if she wants to just kill the ball right there.
Unreal. Unreal. She's great behind the serves. She could level this. She really could.
We'll find out soon. I love this, Fraser. I love this absolutely. Keen to know what will be the next serve from Miwa. Is it going to be the shovel or the pendulum?
We don't have to wait long, thankfully.
Any bets?
I think it's the shovel by what she's looking like here. It is. And she indeed does level.
How brave is this 14-year-old young girl from Japan? She is absolutely fearless, playing somebody double her age, much more experienced, but look at her, absolutely killing it.
Last 6 of the 8 points, but let's not forget the net that happened for Chun Soo Yu the last time this happened in this match. Will it happen again? It won't. No luck to help Chun this time. Goodness me. Can she do it, Miwa? She's 1 point away from a place in the last eight. Her rise is fast.
Probably following the footsteps of her brother, who won the previous match.
Ooh, maybe that was forehand territory. It was half long and diggy.
And that was a great receive from Chun Soo Yu. It was the opposite spin of what Miwa threw at her.
Unreal athleticism from Chun Soo Yu. Miwa Hanamoto on the front foot. A drop shot attempt. And Chun Soo Yu wins a point that you would count her out of usually.
And the crowd here in Goa is going absolutely berserk looking at this level of women's table tennis, what India has not seen as yet.
You have to love that. Even if you're Miwa Hanamoto, but she will not love the score. No. Where have these rallies come from Chun Soo Yu?
And look at how both the players are rising up in their level of game. Suddenly we are pushed behind the table than what we've not seen so far.
Definite entertainment level. The highest level for Miwa Hanamoto stays up. And the same for Chun Soo Yu. That is the highest level of play. But definite shot-making ability that we're seeing is coming out here in the tighter moments. But it's Chun Soo Yu that went back both times in the last 2 points. This time she stays close. And Miwa Hanamoto wins the exchange. Another match point here. Reverse pendulum and a forehand slap. Miwa Hanamoto is through. She beats Chun Soo Yu for the second time.